So why did you take this film on?
Quite frankly, because the Liz Hanna's original screenplay and then Josh Singer's adaptations, continued work on that, just sang out loud and clear. It's almost a quaint revisit to a time when the First Amendment and the Fourth Estate were under attack from the man at 1600 Pennsylvania Avenue,
yeah,
the residences,
and the powers that
put him there. The Pentagon Papers, talk about the elusive quality of the truth. I'm amazed about the Pentagon Papers because the Secretary of Defense put out this query. It says, can somebody provide me with a comprehensive history of our involvement in Vietnam?
Yeah.
And so they did. And that truth was so volatile and so, what's the word I'm looking for? Almost so toxic to at that time, the present day, that no one wanted to talk about it. It's not a good circumstance.
Thanks for doing it, but put it aside.
Yes, please,
now, right?
Keep it out, yeah, and make sure nobody, yeah, sees it. And if that truth gets out, it's an act of treason. That's essentially what the Pentagon Papers case was. And God bless the New York Times and Neil Sheehan for exposing it. And they experienced what? Literally, they were shut down by the government and told not to. And Ben Bradley in the Washington Post and Kay Graham for about a week, not only altered the state of their newspaper empire, but they also altered the state of the First Amendment and the history of the world. By what? By what? By printing the truth. Dear Lord, if that's a dangerous thing to do, we're in bad place.